we are going to discuss axonometric projections. In case of axonometric projections, it allows projection plane to move relative to the object and classify by how many angles of a corner of a projected cube are the same. So if you consider this particular corner of this projected cube, so how many angles are you getting? We are getting three angles, theta 1, theta 2 and theta 3. If neither of these angles are equal, that will be known as trimetric. When two angles are equal, that will be dimetric, otherwise it will be known as the isometric. So I think it is better to go for this respective diagram. So here you see we are having this A and B, these two angles. When A is equal to B is equal to 30 degree, and then we are getting this AB is equal to AC is equal to AD. So AB, AD and AC, these three sides are same from this respective projection, then it is known as isometric projection here. And in case of A is equal to B but not equal to 30, in that case we can go for AB is equal to AC but it is not equal to AD, it is known as dimetric projection, and accordingly the projection has been shown. But when A is not equal to B, so AB is not equal to AC is not equal to AD, then it is known as trimetric projection. So this is the dimetric, trimetric and isometric projections. Lines are scaled, that is a foreshort ended, but can find scaling factors, and lines preserved but the angles are not. So projection of a circle in a plane but the plane is not parallel to the projection plane will be projected as an ellipse. Can see the three principal faces of a box like object. Some optical illusions are possible. So parallel lines appear to diverge. Does not look real, but far objects are scaled the same as the near objects and used mostly in our CAD applications. So in this way we have discussed different applications, advantages and disadvantages of axonometric projections. Thanks for watching this video.